Hey there, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Rohit and today we have something really exciting in store for you. We are going to dive into a simple expo project using React Reanimated. But here is the catch. We are not just going to get the desired result. Instead, we are going to come up with something interesting and engaging. So fasten your seatbelts and let's get started. To begin, we need to initialize our expo project. So open your terminal and let's create a new project. Give it a catchy name and let the magic unfold. Once that's done, we will move on to downloading the necessary dependencies. The first step is to install the Reanimated library package. Don't worry, I will guide you through it. Just follow the commands shown in the official documentation and we will have it up and running in no time. Now if we scroll down a bit, you will notice that we also need to add the React Native Animated plugins to our babel.config.js file. It's a small but crucial step, so make sure you don't miss it. This will ensure that your animations work smoothly and seamlessly. Next up, we need to install the React Native Gesture Handler. This library is essential for our project, so let's get it installed. And don't forget to import it at the top of our app.js file. Following the official documentation is the way to go. Before we jump into writing the code, let's take a moment to run our project and make sure everything is working perfectly. It's always good to double check and avoid unnecessary bugs or hiccups along the way. Great! Now that our project is up and running, let's start by adding a cool title to our application. We will spice it up with a little bit of styling to make it stand out. Not bad at all. Our title is looking just fine, but wait, we are not stopping there. We are about to unleash some serious interactivity. We import the necessary components from React Native Reanimated and React Native Gesture Handler libraries. Our goal is to create an interactive card that can be moved around the screen using touch gestures. Let's break down the code step by step. First, we define a constant card size with a value of 100, representing the width and height of our card. Feel free to adjust this value according to your preference. Inside the app component, we start by creating two shared values, x and y, using the useShareedValue hook. These shared values will hold the current position of our card on the x and y axis. Next, we define a function called panHandler using the useAnimatedGestureHandler hook. This function handles the touch gestures on the card. Inside the panHandler, we have three main event handlers: onStart, onActive, and onInd. In the OnStart handler, we stored the initial position of the card in the CTX object, short for context. This allows us to keep track of the starting position when we start dragging the card. The OnActive handler is triggered when the user is actively dragging the card. It receives the event and CTX objects as parameters. We update the X and Y shared values by adding the translation values from the event object to the initial position stored in the CTX. This results in a smooth dragging effect. Finally, in the onEnd handler, we use the withSpring function to smoothly animate the card back to its original position by setting the X and Y shared values to 0. Moving on, we create a card style using the useAnimatedStyle hook. This hook allows us to dynamically update the style of our card based on the shared values. In this case, we apply a translation transform to the card based on the current X and Y values. Inside the return statement, we have the JSX code for our application's UI. We have a view component with a container style which serves as the main layout. The pan gesture handler component listens for touch events and triggers the pan handler function we defined earlier. It passes the gesture event to the pan handler, allowing us to track the movement of the card. Inside the pan gesture handler, we have an animated.view component representing our card. We apply the card style to this component, which updates its position based on the X and Y shared values. Lastly, we have a status bar component to ensure a consistent look across different devices. And that's it. But now, let's address a little issue we encountered while testing our code. When we tried dragging the ball card right, left, up, down, it didn't move. Wait a minute, we did everything right, didn't we? To find out what went wrong, I decided to take this small project to Snack Expo. For those of you who don't know, Snack Expo is a platform provided by the Expo where you can write code for mobile apps and test it on multiple platforms simultaneously, including Android, iOS and web. So I copied my code and pasted there. Then I installed the necessary dependencies by clicking on add dependencies at the bottom of the screen. First, I tested the code for the web and guess what? The ball animation worked fine. Our ball was moving when dragged and smoothly coming back to its original position. Next, I tried it on Android and unfortunately it didn't work as expected. The ball didn't buzz, it was quite disappointing. Lastly, I gave it a shot on iOS and to my relief, it worked just fine. The ball was moving smoothly as intended. This led me to the realization that our code is correct, but there seems to be an issue with the version of React Native Reanimated used in this particular version of Expo for Android. Curious about this, I did some digging on the internet and found some open issues on GitHub related to this problem. It turns out that other developers were also facing the same issue, and the Expo team acknowledged that there was indeed a mistake related to this version of Expo and React Native Reanimated. Now, Snack Expo showed us that our code works perfectly fine on the web, so let's try testing it locally on our own systems. But hold on, if you try running the npm run wave command in the terminal, you might encounter an error because we haven't installed the required dependencies. So make sure to install them first using the command shown on the terminal window. Alright, our project is working flawlessly on the web. There is a possibility that this issue will be fixed in the upcoming Expo SDK version 49 and then it will start working smoothly on Android 2. Here I want to emphasize an important point. If you ever encounter such problems, don't panic. Instead, double check your code and search for related GitHub issues or developer communities to find possible solutions. One thing you can do is subscribe to this channel and follow me on social media to become a part of our amazing developer community. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching and remember, never stop exploring and learning in the exciting world of React Native Expo. Stay tuned for more exciting videos coming up soon.